Good evening and thank you. I'm Dr. John Irving, our Director of Choral Studies here at CNU. I just want to welcome you to our beautiful Peebles Theater for our concert, An American Tragedy. I first want to begin with a couple thanks. So thank you, Jamestown High School and Matt Rapech, for first meeting me on Dog Street in Williamsburg when we had this crazy idea to collaborate in a world that's beginning to open up again after being isolated for a couple years. And we have several others joining us today, namely Hampton Roads music educators, as we explore gun violence in schools with our program. You can just make sure that your phones are turned to silent and refrain from any flash photography or recording. This is American Breakfast.
Since 1970, there have been 2,070 school shooting incidents in America that have claimed over 3,000 lives. So far this year, there have been over 150 incidents of gunfire on school grounds, resulting in over 60 deaths and countless injuries, many of which were children. This has left families broken, knowing that they will never see their children come home from school. We remember their stories and their lives, the lives they lived richly while on this earth, and their memories that live with us today.
We remember the fellow teachers, parents, families, and communities of lives lost too soon. Together, we carry the wounds within our hearts and our minds. We, as our nation's youth, ask to join our voices together and use the collective power in which we all share. And before we begin, we invite you to join us in a moment of silence to honor and remember the lives lost in senseless acts of gun violence from across our nation and in our own backyard.
The first work you will hear is American Breakfast. This composer uses words from an instruction manual of a firearm to challenge our desensitization to reoccurring gun violence. I was 6 years old when the Virginia Tech shooting happened. I was 11 years old when the Sandy Hook Elementary School shooting happened. More than 320,000 students have experienced gun violence at school since Columbine in 1999. I realized at 11 that I could no longer convince myself that I was truly safe in school. Gun violence happens in our community, in gas stations I visit, in neighborhoods I lived in schools less than 5 miles from this spot. To people I know, to friends that I love, to me and to you. Today, I am 21 years old, and I'm about to teach in a classroom of my own. I must consider how close my classroom will be to an exit and how many children I can fit into a closet or a filing cabinet. And I understand that one day, my students and I may suddenly lose our lives in a school. In order to evoke change, we must first recognize that we are no longer willing to accept this American tragedy. We must turn our pain into action. This evening, we recognize once again.
Semi-automatic. Shall be.